Let's say you have a pump and would like to implement a preventative maintenance program. Firstly, you need to determine the time period that the pump was running. This total hours can then be checked against the replacement period as indicated in the pump manufacturer's datasheet. Every 10,000 hours as an example. If you have a pipe point recording the status of the pump, so when it is on or off, you can report the preventative maintenance program by using the time filtered function. This function returns the amount of time that a performance equation evaluates to true during a specified time period. For this function, instead of specifying the data item, we need to specify an expression that would follow the performance equation format. For our example, the expression would be pump status equals to on. If you are not familiar with the performance equation syntax, I recommend you checking out our online documentation to learn more about it. I will leave a link for you in the video description. Okay, let's practice using this function. So we want to determine the amount of time a controller has been in a cascade state. The controller is the digital point named CDM158 and has 5 discrete states. We are only concerned with the cascade state at this time. Let's begin by creating a label for the output cell in Excel called Time in Cascade Mode Hours. Now choose an empty output cell, select the time filtered function. For the expression, let's write CDM158 in single quotes equals to cascade in double quotes. For the start time, write T minus 3D, so today at midnight minus 3 days. For the end time, T. For the time unit, select hours. And click on OK. The result shows us the number of hours our time controller has been in the cascade state in the time range that we specified. This concludes our video on using the PyDataLink time filtered function. Thanks for watching.